Welcome to ICT Academy Dialogue. In the first Lok Sabha polls conducted in 1951, India had around 173 million voters out of an overall population of 360 million people. The voter turnout was 61%. Since then, India has been facing a lot of voter turnout percentage fluctuation. This is due to geographical restrictions, people moving abroad, and people not serious about casting their vote, the democratic responsibility. Here is a democratically responsible citizen, Guru Swami, who has come up with an Android app for voting. Welcome, Guru Swami.
Thank you.
Please introduce about yourselves.
I'm Guru Swami from Alamarthapatti, okay, which is the nearest rural village of Sivakasi. I have completed my BE Computer Science and Engineering in Chindu College of Engineering and Technology, Madurandagam. I'm the son of Karpasami and Vijay Lakshmi. My father and mother are daily wages. My father is working in printing press. My mother is working in matches industries.
Okay.
I have one brother and one sister.
What made you think that you should change the voting system?
Voting is one of the powerful tools of democracy, which decides the fate of the nation. Every citizen should cast their vote, realizing their responsibilities. I would like to share something that happened in my life. When I was my 6th standard, my father was in abroad. He was not able to cast his vote because of the geographical restriction then. That was the moment I thought that I should do something to change the voting system.
Guru Swami, tell me how your app works.
My app contains three modules. First one is election commission, second one is voter, third one is result. The election commission could also upload the database of the contestants. The second module is voter. Only this option will be enabled for the voters. Using this option, the voter can log in to vote with their fingerprint. Once they give their fingerprint, the backend verifies the fingerprint with the database. If it matches, it allows the voters to vote. Once the authentication is completed, the list of candidates will pop up. The voters can vote as per their choice. The third module is result. This option gets enabled only after the completion of the election. It adds transparency to the announcement of results. Using this option, the people can view the results immediately.
Guru, you say that your app authenticates the voters using the fingerprint reading option available on their phone. What if they don't have an option in their phone? What alternative do you suggest?
That's a good question. I'm working on adding another feature to this app to read the fingerprint, even on phones that doesn't have fingerprint reading option.
Is this app patented, and have you taken this to the notice of Indian Election Commission?
Yeah, I have applied for the patent and I have taken this app to the notice of the Election Commission.
Through whom did you get your app reached to the Indian Election Commission?
Through our principal, Mr. A. Mohammed Abdul Qadir.
Okay, principal of your college where you graduated from.
Yeah.
Okay. Who guided you creating this app?
Initially, I attended a workshop to develop Android application organized by the Kanithamil Peravai. Following which, I started creating this app with the help of Mr. M. Yelumalai, Assistant Professor, the Department of Computer Science and Engineering,
okay,
who guided me and stood with me in hard times.
What are the recognitions and awards you have received so far?
I have received the district level first place in the Project Expo conducted by the Department of Employment and Training, Tamil Nadu. Then I received Kalamin Kanavu Manavan 2018 award given by the Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam Education and Greenery Trust. After that, I was conferred the Young Scientist Award by the Moral Foundation, Trichy. Also, my project was selected as one of the best projects out of 50 projects across Tamil Nadu by Science City, headed by Mr. Sahayam IAS.
Being an engineering graduate inspired you making this app, or your drive for innovation made you choose engineering as a course?
My drive for innovation was the primary reason that made me choose engineering course. Engineering also helped me to refine my innovative skills. I was mentored mainly by the Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam Innovation Center at Chendu College of Engineering and Technology, Madurandagam, from where I graduated which still incubates innovative minds on the campus.
What's your opinion? Is engineering boring or interesting?
In fact, engineering is an interesting course. Engineers are the pillars of the nation. They have a lot of responsibilities to develop the nation. But the painful fact is that most engineering students get carried away in their environment. If they realize their nation-building responsibility, then engineering will not be boring.
Guru, tell me what other initiatives you are into.
I'm creating an app for farmers.
Okay.
Farmers are working hard to feed us, but they're not able to sell their products directly to the customer. This app will remove this gap. I will dedicate this app to the farmers.
Guru, it was nice meeting you. We wish you all success in all your future endeavors. We wish to see you as a great scientist and an innovator in the future. Thank you.
Thanks.
This episode of ICT Academy Dialogue featured Guru Swami, the man who created an Android app for voting from home. Hope this episode would have enlightened you. Stay with us every Friday, 4 p.m. We are open to interview you if you are an achiever, an entrepreneur, a visionary, a leader in any walk of life. Write to us at editor@ictacademy.in.